Hi viewers, in this video we are going to learn the circulatory system of scolyodon. This scolyodon belongs to subphylum vertebrata and the class Chondrichthyes. Okay, coming to the circulatory system. In this circulatory system we are going to learn about the blood, then heart and pericardium of scolyodon, then arteries, that means arterial system, then veins, that means venous system. So first let us start with the blood. So this is the circulatory system of the fish. So here we see heart. So this is the heart which is present behind this pharynx region. It is a tubular S-shaped heart. Then we see the arteries and veins. So these blue color vessels are called the veins. All these veins, they collect the deoxygenated blood from this body organ. So from this various parts of the body, the deoxygenated blood is collected by these veins, and the deoxygenated blood is pumped into this tubular heart. From this tubular heart, the blood is pumped into the gills. So the gills are the respiratory organs. So this deoxygenated blood becomes into oxygenated blood in the gills. Then from the gills, the blood is collected by the dorsal aorta. So from the ventral aorta, the blood is pumped into the gills, and from these gills, the dorsal aorta receives blood and it pumps this oxygenated blood into the various parts of the body. In fish circulation, the blood flows only once in this heart. So this kind of circulation is called single circulation. Since the deoxygenated blood flows in this heart is called venous heart. So from the heart, the blood is pumped into the gills by this ventral aorta. So this kind of circulation is called branchial circulation. In the pulmonary circulation, the blood is pumped into lungs from the heart, but in a fish, the blood is pumped into the gills for the purification of this deoxygenated blood. So these are the important characteristic features of this circulatory system. Apart from that, the one more point is that this heart contains only two chambers, so auricle or atrium and then the ventricle. In addition to these two chambers, two accessory chambers are present. So two true chambers plus two accessory chambers are present in the fish circulation. The accessory chambers are called sinus venosus and conus arteriosus. So sinus venosus and conus arteriosus, these two are present. These two are the accessory chambers. First let us learn about this blood. This blood flows in the arteries and veins, that means the blood flows in these vessels. It is a red color fluid. It consists of two parts, plasma and blood corpuscles. So plasma and blood corpuscles, two parts are present in the blood. The blood corpuscles are two types in the fish. They are called RBC and amebocytes. These amebocytes are similar to the leukocytes, that means they are similar to our WBC. That means the human WBC is similar to these amebocytes. And this RBC contains a blood pigment which is required for the transport of the respiratory gases, that is called hemoglobin. Unlike human RBC, this RBC is a nucleated oval shaped RBC. So this is about the blood. Blood is a fluid which flows in the blood vessels, so that means both in the arteries and veins, and this blood is helpful for the exchange of respiratory gases as it has the hemoglobin in its RBC. So next is the heart. Let us discuss about heart. This heart is present beneath this pharynx region. So this is the pharynx. So the walls of the pharynx has the gill slits. So beneath this pharynx, this heart is present. Let us see the structure of this heart. So this is the heart. This heart is consist of four chambers. As I said, the first chamber is called sinus venosus, and the second chamber is called atrium, and the third chamber is called ventricle, and fourth chamber is called the bulbous arteriosus or the conus arteriosus. This sinus venosus, it receives the deoxygenated blood from all body organs by Guerin duct and hepatic sinuses. So these two, they brought the deoxygenated blood into this sinus venosus. They are Guerin duct and hepatic sinuses. So we are going to learn about this Guerin duct and this hepatic sinuses in detail in the venous system. In these four chambers, this atrium and ventricle, they are considered as the true chambers, but not this sinus venosus and bulbous arteriosus. These two are called as the accessory chambers. This heart is a S-shaped structure. We can see here it is a S-shaped structure. So the first chamber is called the sinus venosus. It receives the deoxygenated blood from this hepatic sinuses and the Guerin duct. So a pair of this hepatic sinuses and a pair of Guerin ducts, they brought the deoxygenated blood into the sinus venosus, and the walls of sinus venosus are very thin. Here you can see the walls of ventricles are so thick in these four chambers. The walls of this sinus venosus, they are very thin, and this sinus venosus opens into this next chamber of the heart, that is called auricle by sinoauricular valve. So this sinoauricular valve is present between the sinus venosus and the auricle, and this sinoauricular valve prevent the backflow of blood. So the blood flows only in one direction, so it cannot flows in the opposite direction. So this sinoauricular aperture is guarded by this sinoauricular valve. So this sinoauricular valves, they prevent the backflow of this blood. And also this part is very contractile, so highly contractile part is this sinoauricular aperture. So therefore this part acts as the pacemaker in the fish heart. So the contractions of the heart starts in this sinoauricular region. The next chamber is called the atrium or auricle. It is larger than this sinus venosus, and also the walls are thicker than this sinus venosus. So this auricle walls are more thicker than this sinus venosus, and it receives the blood from this sinus venosus. And this auricle opens into this ventricle region. So this auricle opens into this ventricle port by this auriculoventricular walls. Two walls are present in between this auriculoventricular aperture, and these two walls, they prevent the backflow of blood. That means flowing of blood from this ventricle into the auricle. So only blood flows from this auricle into this ventricle, but not from the ventricle to the auricle. The next part of the heart is called ventricle. So the walls of this ventricle are very thick. We can see here they are very thick walls than even this atrium and even this sinus venosus and conus arteriosus. As we know that the blood from this ventricle reaches to conus arteriosus. From conus arteriosus it reaches to the ventral aorta. So from ventral aorta it reaches to the bronchus region, that means gills. After purification, that means after exchange of gases, the blood from this bronchus region is collected by the dorsal aorta. From dorsal aorta, the blood is pumped to all body organs. So in order to pump this blood to all body organs, this ventricle must have the thick contractile body wall. So this muscular thick body wall helps to pump this body to all parts of the body organs. Is not a flat surface, so it forms some projections, and because of these projections the wall appears like some spongy like material. So this kind of spongy structure in the heart is called chordate tendine. So this is called chordate tendine. So this chordate tendine develops by the fibers of this internal wall of this ventricle. Then this ventricle posteriorly it becomes narrow and forms a tubular structure. So this tubular structure starts at the posterior part of this ventricle. So this tubular structure is called the conus arteriosus or bulbous arteriosus. The cavity of this conus arteriosus has two valves. So two rows of valves are present here. They are called semilunar valves. So two rows of semilunar valves are present in this tubular cavity. These semilunar valves also they prevent the backflow of blood, that means coronary arteries into the ventricle. So only blood flows from the ventricle into the coronary arteries, not from the coronary arteries into the ventricle. Then this coronary arteries, it comes outside of the pericardium. So all these four chambers, they are covered by the pericardium layer. So a two-layered structure is present around these four chambers. That two-layered structure is called pericardium, which protects this heart from the external sacs. From this pericardium, this coronary arteries projects outside, and the structure which comes outside of this pericardium is called the ventral aorta. So this is the structure of the heart. Here the sinus venosus and this atrium, they receive the blood, and this ventricle and this coronary arteries, they pump the blood to the various body organs. The blood from this ventral aorta reaches to branchus region. From branchus region, they reaches to this dorsal aorta. From the dorsal aorta, they reaches to the various body organs. From various body organs, the blood is collected by this venous system. So from the venous system, it reaches to the heart. Only once the blood flows in the heart in this circuit, therefore this kind of circulation is called single circulation. In order to pump and receive the blood, these four chambers they have to contract and relax rhythmically or systematically. So the contractions of these chambers are called the systole, and the relaxation of these chambers are called the diastole. So when sinus venosus contracts, this atrium relaxes, and so the blood from this sinus venosus pumped into this atrium. Then contraction starts in the atrium, then relaxation is seen in this ventricle. So when the atrium contracts and this ventricle relaxes, the blood from this atrium is pumped into this ventricle. Then contraction is seen in this ventricle, and the relaxation is seen in this bulbous arteriosus or coronary arteriosus. When this ventricle contracts and this bulbous arteriosus relaxes, the blood from this ventricle flows into this bulbous arteriosus. So then blood from this bulbous arteriosus flows into this ventral aorta. So there is no valve between the bulbous arteriosus and the ventral aorta, that we must remember. So only valves are present between the sinus venosus and atrium, and in between the atrium and ventricle, and then finally in between this ventricle and this bulbous arteriosus are the coronary arteriosus. So all these four chambers, they are covered by the pericardium. Here we can see this is the pericardium, and all these four chambers are present inside of this pericardium. So this heart is present beneath this pharynx region, and it collects the blood from all body organs by the venous system. It pumps blood to the all body organs by the arterial system. So this is about the blood and the heart and the pericardium. So in our next video, we are going to learn about arterial system of fish in detail, then also the venous system of fish in detail.
Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe for my channel.